I stand up and pull my phone out of my bag. I'm calling the police.
I don't think so.
Dr. Nick is suddenly and inexplicably next to me, gripping my wrist, pulling my phone from my hand.
What?
I stare at him.
How?
Nothing on earth moves so fast. I feel my stomach dip and the bile rise. Nothing on earth. I think of the huge creature I looked after in the basement. A supposed new species of bear, previously undiscovered, found in the heart of the Amazon jungle. I always knew it was bullshit. The thing looked like a gargoyle.
Ah,
Dr. Nick says as he drops my phone and casually crushes it under his heel. He gently pushes a lock of hair away from my face.
The penny drops.
You're not human.
I stumble over the words. He throws back his head and laughs. The only way I can describe the sound is demonic.
But we've worked together for 3 years.
It's the reason I trusted him. My voice is shrill, and I hate the note of terror riding underneath. Dr. Nick's eyes glow red.
Shame.
He shakes his head.
You're a pretty little thing under all this.
He pulls at the remaining green on the end of my hair.
I'd have liked you for myself, but the Great One had other plans for you.
The Great What? Have you heard yourself?
I feel a manic laugh rising, one which will have an intensity to rival even his.
I do not want to be pregnant, do you understand?
I poke him in his chest with my free hand. His body is hot, burning up even.
You should have thought about that before you signed my contract,
Dr. Nick says, a piece of paper appearing in his hand out of thin air. My signature glows on it. Bright and taunting.
You and your unborn baby are ours.
No!
I grind out, twisting in his grip, which is superhumanly strong. The door to his office snaps open with a rush of unnatural wind. I've made the biggest mistake of my life. Stood in the doorway, filling it and some, are two more of the monsters from the basement. Stone gray with glowing yellow eyes, claws, and fangs. They're wearing only the briefest of cloths around their waists.
Now,
Dr. Nick reaches into a drawer on his desk and extracts a syringe.
I don't want the goods damaged in transit, so you're going to sleep like a good little human.
I struggle against him, but one of the behemoths grabs me from behind, effectively encasing me in stone. As the needle pierces my wrist.
Welcome to your new life.
I hear him say down a long black tube.
You won't enjoy it.